Sometimes I wonder, why me? Why do I have to go through this waiting till marriage thing? Or why do I have to be one of the chosen many to be single at this age? I'm 31, not married, and no kids. And like many other of my fellow millennials out here, we may be wondering, why am I not where I want to be yet? Why does this feel like a trial? Why does this feel like so much pain and pressure? It's like we don't want to face these trials and face these problems that we have to overcome because the problems and the trials are inconvenient. They're not on the time like we want them to be. If we have to go through something, they just come whenever they want to. We can't schedule our problems. We have to go through it and we have to persevere. We have to keep holding on to God's hand. And I don't know about you, but that's hard. That's hard. But what if I told you that persevering through your trials helps someone else? I mean, we hear that often times in messages that you go through for someone else, or your mess is a message, your test is a testimony. Yeah, that's cool. But when you're actually going through it, you're just like, I'm not thinking about that. I'm not thinking about my testimony and how it's going to impact the nations. I'm talking about I'm feeling uncomfortable right now. Yes, that sounds super fleshy, but that's real. So, can we get real for a second about going through trials and how persevering through our trials will help someone else? Your testimony, your story, your opinion, your mind, your voice, it matters. Especially in a day and age like this. And that's why this episode is all about that. Let's join this journey together, persevere through our trials. This is your host, Tatiana Green, and you're listening to Journey Through 30. Go through trials. Well, at least 100% of the way. A lot of times we go through hard times because we either need to learn a lesson, or God is developing us, or He's trying to get our attention. But we never think of how what we go through impacts other people. Even in those circumstances when you are trying to make it happen, you're trying to be successful, you're trying to pursue your dreams, you're trying to do the right thing, and your perseverance, your story in the meantime can really inspire and help someone else. And what happens when you persevere and actually succeed, you actually accomplish a goal, you actually get through it? I can tell you there have been many times where what I felt like were trials and tests and stretching moments in my faith, they have definitely come through and allowed me to have more perspective, more faith, and more power behind what I said when it came to sharing my story with other people to help them. One of the examples that happened recently was earlier this year, 2017. I was helping a sister in Christ of mine with her own book launch that she was doing. She called me and she wanted to get some clarity on how this whole book launch party thing goes. I had a book launch party in October 2016 for Journey to 30. And so she knew about that. She wanted to get my opinion on how to go about doing the books. Like, if they don't come on time, what happens? She had her books published, but they were not ready in time for the party. She only had a small limited number to work with. Little did I know that was not only her story, but that was my story. In my own book release party, I had to tell everybody, hey, yeah, my book about deadlines? Yeah, that book didn't make its deadline to get to this destination. I'm sorry. I'm going to have to take orders for these books and mail it to you all later. And that's exactly what happened. That to me was a trial, but it was also a testimony in the making. So throughout the whole process of creating a book, publishing a book, I went through some ups and downs, but a lot of it was pretty smooth, like 75% of the process was smooth. So when we get to the publishing time, I wanted it to be done on my birthday. My birthday was October 28th, 2016. when the book was to be released. So the book was available on time, but the books themselves that I ordered for the party were not there. Do you know how bummed out I was? On top of having to plan this party and get these little details together, try to get the finances to get the things that I needed for this party still, I had to deal with missing books. Well, not missing, but books that were going to be late. I had to make it work and just be thankful in the time being, like, look, at this point, it doesn't matter. The books are done. I'm a published author. Like I said, I wanted to be when I wanted to be. That happened. The books aren't here, but I can still make orders for people. I can still send it out to them. I can still sell the books at another time. So I thank God for my friends and my colleagues who were there to help support me that day. For my best friend, Alicia, taking the orders for people while I was out and about talking to people and things like that. Taking the money for me, taking the orders for me. I appreciate that because she's a better numbers person than I am. And just coming to terms with everything that happened is like, man, I couldn't do what I wanted to do, but it's the party still happened. People still had a good time. People still got a chance to experience what Journey to 30 was about. And that's what they came for. They came to see me because it was my birthday and they came to support a book. So I'm grateful for that. So fast forward to early 2017. So my friend is telling me her story, that the books aren't going to be there. And so I'm giving her my testimony of what I went through. I'm like, look, God's going to make it work. Here's how you can go and do this. Here's how you can help, like, take orders for books. You could put a certain number of books over here, you know, and make it work. And so she was encouraged by that, because what I went through let her know that she's not alone, one. And two, she's able to, like, not overthink things and be like, oh, I don't have my books, it's over, like, and cancel her party. Like, no, we're gonna have a good time. We're gonna celebrate life. We're gonna celebrate you becoming an author. People are gonna order the books and we're gonna have a good time regardless of it not being the way that we may have thought it to be 100%. I just felt in that moment that what I went through was for someone else, for God to help me and give me strength and give me resources through other people, and to just give me a peace about not getting what I needed that day, my books on time. I was able to help someone else who ran into the same situation that I did. Like, out of all the people, she talked to me. That's a God-ordained situation. So I don't know what specifically you've gone through. It could be totally harsher and darker and scarier than something that I went through that I should just share with you. But what you've been through and what God brought you out of, you persevering through that trial, through those obstacles, defeating those demons, and just going on the journey, just starting, just walking, that's enough right there to inspire someone else, to help someone else to take the first step on their own path to get to where they need to go. So many times I say, like, I love the book, Journey to 30, but the process to create the book help so many people, and not only help people understand, like, writing is not as hard as you think, or becoming author is not as hard as you think it could be, but the process of becoming an author, everybody asks about that, like, how do you do it, like, let me tell you, and I'm happy to tell you, because God is so faithful to help us. Your testimony, your vulnerability, and your struggle all have value. Each one of those things that you've gone through and persevered through and are currently persevering through have value, have lessons and truth that is needed today. And so you may get to the point where you're at, why me? Why did I have to go through that? Why did I have to go through that trial? Why did I have to go through those relationships? Why did I have to go through that abuse? Why do I have to be single beyond 30? What you're going through is for someone else too. A lot of the times it could be God's unique way of getting you to your destined place. We're not going to have the smoothest track to our destiny. And as you hear so many great people share their stories, share their testimonies, you listen to what they've been through and you compare it to your own life, you're like, Lord, you took it easy on me because I don't think I could handle this. Have you heard Joyce Meyer's story? Joyce Myers is a renowned female pastor, preacher, author, and she's a dynamic woman of God. She shared her story of being sexually abused and molested by her own father for years. Can you imagine going through incest, perversion, and all these other dark secrets and having to share that experience with millions of people? And how God delivered you and God prepared you and used you to help free other people. Can you imagine having that mentality of, well, why not me? That's hard to say when we go through these trials. Why not me? But it's God asking us to shift our perspective. When we focus on our trials, we are limited by our own strengths. We're limited by our own abilities. Like, oh man, I can only do so much. I got all the stress, you know, I got all these other things going on in my life. They're really challenging. But God is asking you to take your focus off your problems, off your trials, and focus on Him. To see that there's bigger than you, and that you're going to get not only through this, but you're going to get other people through the same thing. This leads me to the book of James, chapter 1, verse 2 through 4. Consider it pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith develops perseverance. Perseverance must finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. I love that verse because it tells us that, yeah, we're going to go through hard times. We're going to go through trouble. We're going to go through things that are going to make us uncomfortable and shake up our world. It may seem like it's the end of the world and we can't do anything else. But we are to consider it pure joy when we face these trials, and not just one, but many trials. Because we know that if we are children of God, God is going to get us through each and every trial. He will help us. We got to look at it another way, folks. We can't just look at it like, woe is me, I'm a victim, everything's wrong except for what I did, and not take responsibility for perhaps any actions that we've done to lead to that point. Because honestly, we're grown now, but that doesn't mean that we still make mistakes that lead to consequences we weren't really ready for. But we have to learn those lessons, apply them, and teach someone else. And that's why I wrote Journey to 30, because I made way too many mistakes in my 20s. These lessons are to help them understand that even if they make mistakes, they're still loved. And they don't have to stay in that mess. They can get out of it. They don't have to follow anyone else's footsteps. They can make smarter decisions by learning from other people's mistakes and learning how other people persevered. I like to say this all the time, that the streets is watching. And again, excuse my English, but that's how it's said. The streets is watching. So you gotta make sure that you're doing the right thing because you are a child of God. Because you know you got to do better. And because there's someone on the other end of your obedience, at the other end of your perseverance through this trial, who needs the inspiration to keep going. So I don't know what your story is. I don't know what you're currently going through. I can name you a few things that I'm going through myself. I'm dealing with having to rebudget myself financially because I'm not where I want to be financially. I got debts that I got to take care of and it's overwhelming. But God shows himself consistently to be a provider. And I can't wait to release some kind of publication that talks about being bad, bougie, and broke. That's going to be my testimony. I don't know if it's going to be my next book, but it's going to be my testimony because I see it. I clearly see that I'm persevering through some things in the financial area, but I'm not destitute and I'm not down for the count. God is teaching me, he's pruning me, he's preparing me for a future that's bigger than me. What I'm going through right now is going to help somebody else. You are valuable. Your testimony is valuable. What you're going through right now is not for nothing. You and I, we are in this together. So if you're persevering through something, and you're willing to share, please do so in the comments. I definitely want to check in with you and definitely pray for you. I think that's so important that we pray for one another, keep each other accountable in pursuing our goals and persevering through our trials so that we don't give up. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you for being such a support And I look forward to sharing Journey Through 30 in new ways for you in the new year. So look out for that. All right, this has been your host, Tatiana Green, and you're listening to Journey Through 30.